is there's no one left. There's no one left around Erdogan who is willing, you know, to tell truth to power.
Ülkemizi bunca tuzaktan, bunca badireden nasıl çıkardıysak, Allah'ın yardımı ve milletimizin desteğiyle bu ekonomik kurtuluş savaşından da zaferle çıkartacağız.
So Turkey has a kind of longer term problem. It's typical of many emerging markets in terms of it has relatively low savings rate. So it has a structural current account deficit, right? And it needs to import capital to basically cover that current account deficit. And I guess one of the problems maybe in the last decade is that interest rate has really not been high enough because the central bank has been running very unorthodox monetary policies. Basically, Erdogan's own views on interest rates are very unorthodox. Yeah, he believes that, you know, he wants low interest rates. And I think there wasn't much strategy in that. It was just he wanted interest rates lower. Right. But I think now we've seen some kind of policy form around it. I mean, I think the messaging is, you know, and it's related to elections, obviously, in 2023 or earlier. And the strategy is we're going to cut the interest rates. We don't care about the lira. Basically, the lira can go wherever because we think it will rebalance the current account. And we think making Turkish assets cheap will bring all this investment in. And ultimately, that's going to be good for growth. Right. That's their strategy. You know, short term, he may be able to survive for 6 months with this strategy. He may get him through to early elections if he wants to go for early elections, but it's not sustainable over the long term. And I think what we have at the moment is there's no one left. There's no one left around Erdogan who is willing, you know, to tell truth to power, to tell Erdogan that, you know, again, we respect your views, but in the end, if you don't raise interest rates or not cut interest rates, you know, the consequences, the lira has to depreciate. And I think, you know, in the end, you know, Turkey is the only G20 country operating this unorthodox monetary stance. Even Saudi Arabia, the guardian of Medina and the twin mosques, etc., operates an orthodox monetary strategy, right? It's not doing what Erdogan's doing, right? So, you know, it's very hard to have confidence when the central bank has no monetary policy. You know, you need to find $200 billion of capital every year. And if you don't offer foreigners enough of an interest rate premium, the money's not going to come to Turkey. I mean, that's in essence what it is.
تعلن دولة الإمارات عن تأسيس صندوق استثماري بقيمة 10 مليار دولار للاستثمار في قطاعات استثمارية في جمهورية تركيا.
It's positive that, you know, Turkey and UAE and probably Saudi Arabia are kind of normalizing the relationship, right? It was not particularly healthy for the region that you had this geopolitical competition between these two visions for the region. But the reality is, I think that this is not a bailout, right? I mean, $10 billion doesn't touch the sides. When you think of a $200 billion gross external financing need by Turkey, and really the kind of money it is, right? I mean, the message is this is longer term investment, right? This is not, you know, this is not something that like Saudi Arabia and UAE have done for other countries, like for Egypt, right? They've lent them cash, you know, big cash injections, deposits at the central bank, swap facilities. That's not what it is. This is an investment fund to take advantage of cheap Turkish assets. And so basically UAE in particular is saying, it's interesting what's going on now. We see a lot of value and we think Turkey's a good long-term investment. But, you know, we're not saving Erdogan, right? We think Turkey is a good place to invest beyond the 2023 elections, irrespective of who is in power. The Turks begin to take money out of the banks because they're worried about macro financial stability more broadly, right? I mean, that's the key battleground, I would say, the deposit base. If we see a run on banks, it's game over, right? Turkey doesn't have enough reserves to defend the currency. When people realize that their FX deposits in the banks have kind of been recycled by the central bank to defend the currency, they may worry about that and they may decide we're worried about the stability of the banks itself. And that's the thing to watch for. But I think all the focus is now on this election and getting Erdogan re-elected. Now, the question mark is, can this policy survive to those elections? Or will the whole thing unwind?